belong to our show. If we may lean a little on other review titles, we would like you to lend an ear. And although we're not exactly new faces, we want you to meet some of the people who are going to participate in the show this evening. First, we have Miss Joyce Jameson. And then we have Mr. Len Weinrib, Miss Patty Regan, Mr. Bert Convy, Miss Jackie Joseph, Mr. Ken Berry, Miss Ann Gilbert. At the piano is Billy Barnes, and my name is Bob Rogers. Now, I think it's only fair to explain why the eight of us happen to be here this evening. Well, as for me, when I visited my analyst today, we discovered there was really nothing left to say. We couldn't find a reason, so we blamed it on the season. But he told me as I turned and crawled away, do a review. Do a review. With all your problems is the only thing to do. From Amsterdam to Araby, you'll find no better therapy, so join a group and do a new review. A new review.
A new review. A new review. When I found my lover wasn't coming back, in my suicidal mood I started wearing black. His morbid way of dressing was so dark and so depressing that my friends began to say behind my back,
do a review. Do a review.
With all this basic black, there's nothing left to do.
Your problems you can rectify.
My morning will electrify.
So join a group and do a new review.
A new review. A new review. A new review.
When my uncle died, his dough went to a school. And the only thing he left me was a purple stool. It wasn't what I planned on, but it's strong enough to stand on, so I hit upon a way to play it cool. Do a review.
That's right.
Do a review.
What else? With such a hunk of junk, that's all a guy can do.
The Eckerts and Melziner see a stool and simple scenery.
So join a group and do a new review.
A new review.
A new review.
A new review.
I was working as a Lord and Taylor clerk, but the first day out, they knew I couldn't cut the work. I joked with all their patrons, saved the Lulus for the matrons. When they canned me, they said, Miss, don't be a jerk.
Do a review. Do a review.
You've got a lot of good material, but it's blue. A little joke is bully here. We don't need BS pulley here.
So join a group and do a new review. A new review. A new review. A new review. We've been studying the method for a year,
but the method we were using wasn't very clear.
We need an operation to improve our concentration.
So the teacher said, now pupils, listen here.
Do a review.
Do a review.
Do a review.
Do a review.
This form of nonsense was created just for you.
Del Brando is our favorite lad. Ronnie Graham is not so bad.
We're going to group and do a new review.
A new review.
A new review.
A new review.
We were once a famous acrobatic team. From the strain of triple gainer, someone split a seam.
Heard our costumes ripping, then our fingers started slipping.
As we crashed and burned, we heard our agents scream.
Do a review!
With all these broken bones, nothing else to do.
Hey, Sullivan won't use you now. Perhaps it might abuse you now. To join a group and do a new review.
Do a review.
Do a review.
That's how it happened. Now we're gonna see it through.
We're gonna make a show of all the crazy things we know, of all the crazy things that crazy people do.
We're gonna do, do a renew, do a renew, do a renew.
We don't want to aggravate you.
We don't want to make you mad.
But we're wondering about a problem that is getting kind of bad.
We're wondering where. We're wondering where. We're wondering where are you children tonight?
The little darlings.
Where are you children tonight? The little angels. Where are the sweets? Are they out on the streets?
Are they living it up?
Carrying on.
What do they do when their parents are gone?
Where are your children this morning?
We mean this evening.
Where are your darlings, Mama?
Have they been naughty?
Where do they go when you go to a show?
Are they parking their cars under the stars, rocking and rolling in neighborhood bars?
Maybe they are darlings, maybe they are gems.
But when you catch them smoking, are they smoking L&M's?
They don't care for coffee, all they dig is tea.
And heaven help the nation when the kids are 23. We're wondering,
Where?
Are your children tonight? Where are the babies? Where are your children tonight? Are they in trouble? What do they do when their folks aren't in view?
Are they all by themselves?
Up in their bed.
What's going on in their foul little heads?
Oh, Mr. Elvis Presley and Mr. Tommy Sands.
Yeah.
Overrated juveniles with overactive glands.
You should see Lolita winking at the man. Bleaching her pigtails and painting her toenails. Lolita's only 10.
She's a hot rod baby.
She's a drag strip queen.
She's a Cupid doll at 17.
She loves the cha-cha.
Cries the blue.
Little lipstick and candy in her rubber soul shoes.
With a real cool line.
He's a living teenage Frankenstein.
He's a bright fellow.
And he won't wear a suit.
No. He's wearing a black leather jacket.
Yeah.
And motorcycle boots. They're wondering, where are your children tonight?
Call up policemen.
Where are your children tonight?
Call up patrol car.
See, liquid bound when their folks aren't around. Are they having a ball in with all their mites? We ask the question, parents, where are your children?
Are they at home? In bed?
Asleep?
We would like to pay homage to the rather large strides the field of surgery has taken. Come in, Mount Sinai.
Clamps, clamps, clamps. Suture, suture, suture. Sponge, sponge. Sponge.
You really think we can do it, Doctor?
I mean, transplanting the heart to where the liver should be. It's a delicate operation at best.
Well, we're doing it, aren't we? Didn't we perform the same operation on the cadaver yesterday?
And it was a howling success, wasn't it?
I guess so. Kind of hard to tell on the cold ones, though.
Nonsense!
Nonsense!
Nonsense.
It's very simple. All we do is take the esophagus and place it to the left of the Adam's apple. Then we take the diaphragm and place it to the left. No, the right.
Left.
I know. Gee, if there's one thing I can't stand, it's a smarty skirt assistant. You down there, change places with smarty skirt here. Now, Nurse Guilbert will show you how to properly assist a great surgeon like me. Scalpel!
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 Howdy, Mac. How are you? Having troubles? I am too. What do you do when the girl you love starts giving you the runaround?
Boy, I know. First it's her job and then it's her mother. Then it's always something or other.
What do you do when the girl you love starts giving you the runaround?
Fooling ourselves. Are we just fooling ourselves? Have we been kidding around and sounding like kids in love?
Fooling ourselves. Are we just fooling ourselves? Have we been playing a game and blaming the stars above?
Fooling ourselves that clouds were made to walk on and dance
was that love was made for taking a chance on. Maybe we're wrong to stumble blindly along, not knowing whether or not we're fooling ourselves.
You see, this girl I'm in love with, she's been married before. She says she's afraid to ever remarry. She doesn't want the life she had. I understand, but I really love her. I couldn't see how anything could turn out bad.
This girl I'm in love with, she runs an office. It's pretty big and she's pretty smart. I wouldn't ask her to quit her job. I just want to own a little corner of her.
Ourselves that clouds were made to walk on and dance on, fooling ourselves that love was made for taking a chance on. Maybe we're wrong,
maybe we're wrong
to stumble blindly along.
Parents and teachers of Dingledale Elementary School, and welcome to our little open house. Before we begin, I'd like to introduce our new PTA president, Miss Jameson, who above all is a mother.
Thank you very much, Mr. Rogers. Holy Moses, it's early for a meeting. Andrew Fairley, Mr. Cocktail, sing in here on time. First off, I would like to say that we are needing evidences. Dingledale, we're picking up our children with that cute little bus every morning, dumping the kids back home in the afternoon. But does it have to be quite so early in the afternoon? I would like to make a motion to extend the school day a little bit longer. Say 8 in the evening. Might cost us a little more money this year, but holy Moses, it will be worth it.
Thank you, Miss Jameson. We'll discuss it during the meeting later.
I certainly wish we would.
Right now, you're going to see some of the results of progressive education, which we practice here at Dingledale. Our very own Miss Regan will preside.
Good evening, all. I would like to take this opportunity to thank our principal, Mr. Rogers, for having made me his mistress of ceremonies. This evening, my 3B class has been honored to provide the entertainment for you. So, without further ado, the children will introduce themselves. Children, please. Isn't she a little sweetheart?
Jackie Joseph. Annie Gilbert.
Smile, big smile.
Master Kenneth Berry.
He's a very talented boy, Mrs. Berry. A little unpopular, but very talented. Dear, speak up.
I said I'm going to beat him to a dirty, bloody pulp.
Your name. Your name. Your name. Go on, tell your name.
Bert Convy.
Bert Convy.
All right. All right. Next. Next.
Winnie Weinrib.
Take your seat, Lenny, dear.
Oh, yeah?
Take your seat! Bert!
Well, here's Bert.
Bert!
Well, here's the
Bert! 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 All right. All right.
Look,
look. Little ladies. This evening, the children would like to present for you my master's thesis, which I've been working on at teacher's college for the past 3 summers. I call it a dissertation on transportation. The children like to call it, "It All Started with the Wheel."
It all started with the wheel. It all started with the wheel. It all started with the wheel. It all started with the wheel.
Agga bugga, agga bugga, agga bugga boo. Agga bugga, agga bugga, agga bugga boo. Ow!
Bert.
Oh, sir.
Please. Continue. Please.
At the dawn of time, when the world was new, and the caveman wondered what to do, when he wanted to go from here to there, and he wearied of walking everywhere, well, he cut down a tree with zest and zeal, and he said to himself, "I've invented a wheel!
Ooh, what a dandy deal! He's got man invented a wheel! And the little wheel runs by day, and the big wheel runs by the grace of God, and it all started with a wheel! It all started with a wheel!
Egypt had a pyramid! Egypt had a sphinx!
Egypt had a pharaoh who thought transportation stink. So he said with a smile, "Well, a partial of the Nile is really very smart. But he traveled
on land. Would free be grand if I had myself a cargo?"
Oh, yes, he certainly did.
Yes, 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 he did, did, did.
Grecians too, when they wanted to run around, they'd better find a certain kind of thing to cover ground.
And so they fought both night and day, and on an ancient morn, a clever man got a clever plan, and a chariot was born. Swing home, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home.
Swing home, sweet chariot. Oh, I beg your pardon.
So it went throughout the years, a lot of blood and sweat and tears. Man is such a funny joke, he's gotta go, he's gotta go.
We know where you're going.
Well, now. And Fulton invented a steamboat.
Yeah.
Wright was invented the plane.
Uh-huh.
Ford invented a motor car.
Right, someone invented a train.
And he designed a motorcycle, bicycle, tricycle, every kind of cycle or cycle in the world. Nothing can be cuter than to make yourself screwed out of bamboo cranes and roller skates. When you play on the ground, where you gotta get around.
I like planes, any kind of planes, little model planes, but I always find that I lose my mind for that certain kind with a jet behind. I like planes.
I like cars, any kind of cars, little foreign cars, a special kind that is zebra line, and an Austin coupe or Jagger juke that makes my heart do a loop-de-loop. I like cars.
Sit down. I like a horse, but I want to get back.
I like a wagon.
I like a rickshaw.
I like a fire gun.
Ding, ding, ding. I like a pull cart.
I like a push cart.
go-kart.
Bing, bing, bing.
Bing, bing, bing.
Bing, bing, bing.
Choo, choo, choo. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Drive with the wheel. Drive with the wheel. Drive with the wheel. Drive with the wheel. Drive with the wheel.
I like trains. Any kind of train. Ordinary trains. Especially kind of small and wide. And better on a set that goes from back to the small. Go back to the blue and a back to the small. So fat. And a cow gets a rat. And a bell that rings. And a fist that bling.
I like trains. Every model has its own appeal. But don't forget it started.
Are you the editor of this periodico?
Yes, Joyce, Playboy.
Mm-hmm. And name is Hugh.
Hugh Hefner, that's right.
Hugh. Gee, but you're wonderful, Hugh. Harvey, you. Oh, that's a pretty name.
Thank you.
I wonder, Hugh, if I could ask you sort of a major request.
Of course.
Well, you see, while we've been in New York on Broadway, I've been studying acting in the daytime.
Mm-hmm.
And, well, you see, I'd like to be the first method playmate.
Yeah, well, mm-hmm, that's very interesting.
I mean, I'd like to give the playmate inner life instead of, you know, outward. Well, you know what I mean. I feel that it's important to relate to every one of your readers individually. Liberty and justice for all. You know?
Sort of a patriotic
method
playmate.
The playmate is more than just symbolically a big girl bunny rabbit. You know what I mean? She has to be important. She has to mean something in everybody's life. I mean, she just has to. You know what I mean? Oh, Huey, give her a chance. Give Miss Playmate the method. Allow her to be someone important. Oh, you won't do it. I know you won't.
I will. I will.
Would you do that?
I'll do it, Joyce. We'll work out something
with a
torn T-shirt, and we'll do the whole method
That's right.
thing.
Yes, right. If you could just tell me exactly what the playmate is supposed to do, I'll go home and study it.
Well, we have to shoot test shots first. That's the usual procedure. And I think that you would. I think we can work something out, Joyce.
That would be marvelous. It would be absolutely wonderful, and it would be important.
I think that's the important thing.
Oh, it is.
Important.
Oh.
Well, we try to pick the girls from every walk of life. Some of them are hostesses, airline hostesses, or secretaries, and I'm sure we can work something out.
I'm sorry, you excuse me, but Joyce, our little friends are about to start the second half, and since you're in the first number, it would be very nice if you would join us.
I'll be preparing all the time.
All right, and I'll be in the first row, watching the second half.
Thank you, Huey.
Are you ready?
Yes,
you ready to go?
I'm ready.
You know the way?
Yes,
all right, it's this way, right here.
Right. And we'll be back in just a couple of minutes with the second act of the Billy Barnes Revue.
With a touch of gay Paris. Las Vegas.
Desert Riviera with the charm of Italy.
Las Vegas.
Tourists come to Vegas by the truckload every day.
Las Vegas.
Then they lose their savings, but in such a friendly way.
Oh, everything's gaudier, brassier, bawdier. That's how it is in Las Vegas. Why, it has the charm of any fine old small town, mixed with a kick of a decline and fall town. Everything's merrier, shim and a fairier. That's how it is in Las Vegas. Why, you bet on black and it'll come up red there. Stay up all night and never go to bed there. Things may be sick, but nothing's ever dead there. That's how it is in Las Vegas.
People come in taxi cabs, subway trains, Cadillacs, just to spend a moment in Las Vegas. People come in submarines, in the air, on the track, just out to get their dough spent in Las Vegas.
Ever since the covered wagon rolled to the west, suckers I discovered dragging gold to the west.
People come on roller skates, water skis, pogo sticks, just to spend a weekend.
Present a lovely star from Hollywood making her nightclub debut, whom we got for a mere $200,000 a week, and she's cheap at that price. And here she is, Miss Tanya Conway and her fellas.
Here she is, the darling of Hollywood. Here she is, the star of the screen. Here she is, that glow girl. Oh, oh, girl, go, go, girl. Here she is, Miss Allen personified. Here she is, just waiting for you. Here she is, Miss Tanya Conway, bringing you her own Las Vegas review.
Picture, Long Distance Please. As you recall, Miss Conway had just shot her husband along with the janitors. And just as she was about to make her escape, the telephone rang.
To her, I'm nothing but a chump to her, and
at night I needn't come to her. Whoa, another block.
He said I lost my mystery the tragic day we went.
She says our love is dreary. The thrill is all but dead.
We dress and never peek. Of all we're never cheek to cheek. Of all, in fact, we seldom speak. Of all, except to fill our blocks.
Pride from me, she says the children hide from me. The gap is 10 feet wide from me, and here's another block.
He says my love is grating now, my hum is aggravating now. He feels no urge for mating now. 3 cheers, another.
Says my job is commonplace, my business friends are dull.
He says our home is well on earth, our life's a living hell.
We used to laugh and sing before, we felt the world was spring before. Our hearts would closely cling before we started playing.
About the Beat Generation. However, I've been doing a great deal of reading lately on the subject, and I find that Mort Saul, who is kind of an idol of the Beats, is quoted as saying the following. Actually, the Beats are kind of a lonely group, right? You know, a repressed section of our society. They're sick, right? You know, anyway, I'll read more about that in the next show. Actually, sociologists refer to the Beatnik as a fringe area group with certain lower class tendencies reflected in a negation of society of wage earning. They don't work. Right? You know, our group. Actually, we've got a lot to thank the Beats for, like Lawrence Lipton's fine novel and Zen I Wrote, an in-group joke. Right? You know, they got poetry and jazz, which is kind of weird and salty. You've read it, huh? Too much. Right? You know, then we got 95 cent Sanka, $2 eclairs, and above all, the Beatniks. Go!
If you're bugged with your business, if you're weary of your wife,
don't be dull or dejected. There's a better way of life.
Just forget responsibilities. Prepare to have a treat. Man like
slip to the coffee house and listen to the beat. Yes, we're the Beat Generation, a sorted aggregation. We scorn obligation.
No, we won't conform.
Only the Beat Generation, a modest operation.
We're taking the nation
by a very little storm.
If your world's too much with you and you want to make a change,
grow a beard.
Buy a sweater.
Simply start in acting straight.
You can find a local hangout now on every other street. Man like split to the coffee house and listen to the beat. Beat, 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 listen to the beat. Beat, 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 listen to the beat.
The first thing you've got to do if you want to be the most beat is you've got to dig jazz.
Daddy jazz!
Oh, it's clearing away.
Daddy jazz!
Daddy jazz!
Now, third thing you gotta do. That's really important. You gotta do poetry and jazz. I do a little poem for you. My San Francisco acquaintance of mine, his name is Arnold Moots. Arnold started writing poetry after encountering Jack Kerouac in a men's room at a Greyhound bus station in Merced, California. The name of this here poem is Help. Or Reflections upon encountering Jack Kerouac in the men's room at a Greyhound bus station in California. Help. I saw you, America, standing barefoot in the neon lunch meat supermarkets, dragging your shopping carts through the vegetable aisles till early dawn, looking for a fast fix. Where are you, Diane Vossi? Who bared your brain to heaven on the forecourt of the Grauman's Chinese Theater? Out the freight for nowhere Vermont, seeking eternal light in the city of light eternal. Help, help, help. Let the bongos play. Let the ukes strum out. Let the sax blare on. Don't you ever do that again. Put on your clothes, America. We know you're there. I'm with you in Birdland with the jazz band's cry.
Yeah.
I'm with you in Birdland where there are people dancing on broken Dr. Pepper bottles.
Yeah.
Help, Ruben! Help, Morgan! Help,
America. I dig you.
And there's 100 million others like me.
I'm ashamed to admit it, but I got a job today. Showing tourists the local hangouts, and you won't believe the pay.
My new novel on the beatnik sold, I'll be on Easy Street.
Yeah, man, I just bought a coffee house that caters to the beat.
We were the beat generation, to see the population. We saw the sublimation in the coffee cup, but now we're changing the station. We're earning compensation. This hearty application is really cleaning up. You'd like to try it, won't you kindly be a guest? You can live like a beatnik on the left bank of the west. We're moving to Connecticut to live with the elite. And I can sit to the coffee house and you can add a money.
Stay too long at the fair.
beginning to slow now. Have I stayed too long at the fair? The music has stopped, and the children must go. So very much alone. Here in New York, I'm many worlds away from people who are dear to me. Here in New York, I'm learning every day how very sad a be. I wanted to live in a carnival city with laughter and love everywhere. I wanted somebody to care. I found it was easy to capture success.
Up and have the sun say, howdy buddy, you're the one who is setting my face ablaze. Did you ever have one of those days?
Did you ever get called in by your boss, a gloomy gus who's always cross, and he hands you a healthy raise? Did you ever have one of those days?
Did you ever meet someone thrilling who is willing to be kissed, and you suddenly find she's bringing all the swinging things you missed?
Did you ever look up at skies of blue and know they're blue because of you, and you walk in a happy haze? Did you ever have one of those days?
A cloud is snowing off a silver lining, hoping to win my praise. Did you ever have one of those days? Da di da di da da di da da di da da. Did you ever have
she gladly takes your arm. When I look, the sun is shining. A cloud is showing on the silver lining.
And you think the wind might rain. Did you ever have one of those days?
Look up at skies of black, with Martians planning to attack, with a bomb and some deadly rays. Did you ever have one of those days? We can hear the missiles whining. The papers say the Reds are undermining our whole democratic ways. Did you ever have one of those days? We could laugh at the stormy weather.
As much fun tonight as we have. Remember, we're going to be here again next time, next week, same time, same place, on Playboy's Penthouse, and try to join us then. Till then, good night. Want to say good night?
Oh, yes, it was really a wonderful, marvelous party, and you've got to all come back again next week, because next week it's going to be even bigger and taller.
Taller? Uh-huh. Sure.
Yes.
Let's go dance.
All right.